Hello everyone, welcome back. This is your host Ruby Nakka. In the recent past, I made a video to talk about the importance of talking about adoption to children. In that video, I spoke about why we have to talk, but I did not cover the areas of when to start it and how to talk about adoption to children. So this video is going to talk all about when to start talking about adoption and how to start talking about adoption. The video that I was referring to about the importance of adoption that I had made earlier is available in the description. So if you go to description, there's a link to it. You can view that. Like any Indian, I wasn't any different in terms of thinking about not disclosing about adoption to my girls until I attended the pre-adoption counseling where we met an adult adoptee who enlightened us about the importance of it and how to do it, when to do it. By end of that counseling session, my wife and I have made the decision that we shall talk about adoption to our children. After 1.5 years of my daughter's arrival, my wife and I made a decision that we will start the conversation about her adoption. But little did we know then how difficult it was. I would show my finger at her and say, "You do it." And she would show her finger at me and say, "You do it." So we went back and forth for a couple of months. And luckily, we came across a book called Two Birthdays for Beth. So we ordered it online and we got it and we started reading it. And my daughter instantly fell in love with that book. But she was very young to understand anything, but it didn't matter to us because the book brings up the words called adoption repeatedly. So we were hoping at some point in time that she would start asking questions and we would just answer the questions. But as time went on, one day I was driving and I heard a story about how to open up about adoption to children on the radio, and the story went like this. A couple wanted to adopt a child, so they went to an orphanage and they told the officers at the orphanage that they wanted a child with a brown skin and dark hair and beautiful eyes with clean set of teeth, and they brought this child with a green skin and yellow hair. And the mom and dad said, no, this is not the child we wanted. And then they brought a child with a red skin and green hair. And then also they said, no, this is not the child we wanted. And then, you know, you play with the colors for some time, and the third or fourth child they brought, it is the child that we wanted. It is the child with the brown skin, dark hair, beautiful eyes, clean set of teeth. So I came home and she was lying down right next to me with her leg on top of my tummy. And she was listening to this story I was sharing, and I told her, "Hey, you know, I'm going to tell you a story." And we told her, "Mom and Dad wanted a baby." So we both of us went to an orphanage and we told them that, you know, we wanted a baby like this. And her eyes would become big and she kept listening to me. And when we reached that last part where we said, "Oh, you know, here comes the baby with the beautiful skin and dark hair and nice eyes, clean set of teeth," and she looked at me and she said, was that me? I said, yes, that was you. But mom and dad were jumping up and down and grandparents were jumping up and down, and that's how you came home, we said. This story went on for some time, and every time she wanted to hear this story, she would lie down next to me and she would tell me, "Daddy, tell me that story of the baby with green skin, yellow hair and all that." But after some time, when she was able to identify colors and human body, when I was telling this story once, she told me, "Daddy, there's nobody in this world with green skin and yellow hair." Then I knew that she has grown and my story has to sync with her age. The point in short I'm trying to help you to understand here is this. Whatever you are opening up to the child has to be age appropriate. Don't make it too boring when she's too young, and don't make it too childish as she's growing older. You could also use the stories of your faith if there are any characters in it. For example, in the Bible, I can think of at least three characters, Joseph, Moses, and Esther. All three of them were adopted and they have a very positive outcomes of their adoption. So you can use their stories, but the trick in this is constantly use the word called adoption, so that at least you are trying to build the curiosity in this child to help her to ask you the question, what is adoption? So that you know you can just answer the questions, what is adoption means. So if in your faith, if there are any characters that you could use that were adopted, that would be the best thing that you can ever do to help a child to understand about her adoption. Last part about sharing the information about adoption to children is this. They will have plenty of questions, and as they grow, the questions also can get tougher. But in all this, I want you to remember and understand is this. Whatever you're doing it in the best interest of the child, as the principles of adoption says. When they start asking questions, what do we do? My short answer is this. Do not be afraid. And the long answer is this. In our house, we will never lie to our children. The guiding principle in answering any of our girls' questions is being truthful, even to the point of saying, I do not know, if we really do not know an answer. The point in short is this. Let the truthfulness guide you in everything to do with your children's adoption. It's okay to say, I don't know, if you truly don't know an answer, than to cover it up, you lie about it. Children are smart, as you know. Once they smell something is not right, it's just a matter of time before the doubt becomes an obstacle to weaken your relationship with your child. Today, both my girls are teenagers, and they tell me they would have hated us if we had not told them about their adoption. We're very open about it. Sometimes we laugh about it. Sometimes we all of us sit together and cry together. It's okay, because after all, they're your children. They ought to see your heart and know who you are. And when you do that, your children turn out to be very strong, empowered, and informed. And that's all the information I have about how and when to start sharing the information about adoption. If you like this video, give me a like, comment on it, and most importantly, do not forget to subscribe to this channel. Till we meet again, goodbye.